नमस्कार,
नमस्ते।
नमस्ते।
नमस्कार जी।
नमस्कार।
हाँ,
कमलेश
नमस्कार। नमस्कार कमलेश जी।
चक्रवर्ती, यस, कमलेश चक्रवर्ती
नमस्कार।
सत्या साई फाउंडेशन।
हाँ, आई नो। टुडे मनोज जी एंड उनकी वाइफ बोथ हैव गॉन फॉर द वैक्सीनेशन।
या दैट्स व्हाई दे टोल्ड मी टू रिप्रेजेंट देम।
आई हैड टॉक्ड टू हिम फ्यू डेज बैक दे यू नो ऑल डिटेल एंड देन ही डिडंट मेंशन। Suddenly they realize there's a vaccination date.
I know, I know. So it comes. So I just go on the screen.
नमस्कार संजय जी, संजय त्रिपाठी जी।
तिवारी जी नमस्कार जी। नमस्कार
नमस्कार।
एवरीवन। हाँ
नमस्ते
नमस्कार।
संजय जी।
नमस्ते गुना जी।
नमस्ते नमस्ते।
हाँ
नियरली आफ्टर 2.5 इयर्स है।
या इट्स अ लॉन्ग टाइम। Once in a while we exchange notes, but yeah,
Yeah.
good to see you.
Good. Thank you.
I'm seeing Tripathi ji after Chicago first time.
Yeah, I'm sure, yes.
Yes. संजय जी,
हाँ
संजय कुमार, संजय कुमार जी हमारे, संजय जी एक और हैं।
हाँ बिल्कुल मालूम है, ये लास्ट टाइम भी थे
संजय
भाई। इसलिए
जी आप को होस्ट बना दीजिएगा संजय त्रिपाठी जी को।
चिंता नहीं, मुझे कुछ शेयर नहीं करना है, मैंने कुछ बनाया नहीं है, तो आई विल बी।
अच्छा वर्बली बताएंगे क्या? अच्छा ठीक है।
हाँ नोइंगली मैं बनाया नहीं, कुछ स्लाइड्स वगैरह। यस
ओके ऑल राइट। We are meeting from different time zone now. All get meetings are becoming more international. हाँ
तो गुणा जी, यू आर इन न्यूजीलैंड?
जी। फोर
अच्छा,
टाइम नाउ इन इन योर ऑकलैंड?
4:30 PM जी।
हाँ,
यस सर। या
6 hours द समर टाइम,
सेवन
विंटर
सेवन
टाइम, विंटर टाइम।
Now it is summer, so it is 7 hours.
7 hours.
6 hours.
4:30 now. Bangkok is 10:30.
Oh, okay. So 6 hours. Sorry.
Seven.
Okay, please wait for 5 minutes, then we start the meeting here.
ठीक
संजय जी। तिवारी जी, आप बैंकॉक में, बैंकॉक में तभी ऑलमोस्ट बज रहा है, 10:30 हो रहा है ना? करेक्ट,
हाँ जी, क्या हुआ?
बैंकॉक में 10:30 हो रहा होगा, करेक्ट समय? बहुत लैग है क्या लग रहा है?
आई थिंक सो जी।
सही है, 10:30 जी, 10:35।
या 10:35
तो होडा टीम अभी मैं देखा जो एक ग्रुप बना है उसमें तो काफी लोग हो चुके हैं, तो टीम का फॉर्मेशन धीरे धीरे शुरू हो रहा है या थिंकिंग शुरू हो रही है? 2023 में है ना करंटली प्रोग्राम जो प्लान है?
या 23 में है, तो कोविड में वी कुड ओनली डू ऑनलाइन, सो द बेस्ट इज यू नो वी लर्न द एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ अदर कंट्रीज, व्हाट दे डिड, हाउ दे डिड, एंड आवर मेंबर्स आर गेटिंग बेनिफिटेड एंड दे कमिंग टू नो, एंड वी होप दैट कोविड विल कम इन कंट्रोल इन in a good shape in definitely in 6 months time. It's getting better and better. It became better. But you know, we can have a proper in-person brainstorming sessions, you know, action plan meetings where we all you know, go in the lines of what New Zealand has done, what Australia has done, what we are going to learn today from the United States. So all those things will benefit us. You know, our journey will not be that long. You know, we take the benefit from other countries. You know, we are more, and we are utilizing the COVID time in learning the thing. How, what are important things? How it, when was it formed? How did they go about it? And we are very happy to say we are about 11 organizations are now under under OTA Thailand. And once you know our current team, you know, become more active, more and take up more challenges, what need to be done and how need to be done, then it'll be easier to join more, you know. So we are going step by step, and we have we are very diverse group, not only Hindu. We have a Jain group. We have a Sindhi group, so we want to do it, you know, all like-minded people for the same cause. This is the basic idea. Yeah.
But yeah. So, अभी तक कितने बार call हो चुका है इसका? How many calls?
This is the third meeting. We do it once in 2 months.
Achha.
So this is our third meeting, virtual meeting. The first meeting we heard the coordinator from New Zealand, and the second meeting we heard the coordinator from Australia. And this time we very rightly wanted the speaker from United States, because we also want to know what is going on the dismantling global Hindutva front. What is this motive behind it? There are two things you are going to talk. One is the OTA in the beginning, and later on, then we'll go to that. Yeah. So it'll give a direct our members some idea about what is going on there.
Yeah. नमस्ते संजय जी. नमस्कार जी.
संजय जी आपका अनम्यूट कर लीजिए.
आप म्यूट पे हैं.
हाँ जी. संजय जी नमस्कार जी.
नमस्कार जी. नमस्कार. नमस्कार
जी. गुना जी
नमस्ते.
आप कहाँ पर हैं? न्यूजीलैंड में हैं? कौन भाग कौन दुनिया कौन से कोने में आप?
आई एम इन रोटोरुआ.
पूछना पड़ता है गुना जी कहाँ है इस वक्त.
Is too cold there? What now?
Spring has started, but today is a bit cold.
Okay. I think we start the meeting now. We can't wait more than 10 minutes actually.
Yeah. I agree with you.
So, Sanjay ji and Guna ji, in the beginning, we just maybe we start with the one stanza of Vande Mataram. Tiwari, is that correct? Is it okay?
Yes. Yeah.
So please all keep your back straight, and we will unmute yourself.
Should we unmute? Unmute or what do you?
No, I think you just unmute yourself. Unmute yourself,
yeah.
All of you.
Yeah. Otherwise, there are the voices interfere. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So we all sing Bharat Vandana, Vande Mataram, first stanza. Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Sujalam, Sujalam, Malayaj Sheetalam, Sasya Shyamalam, Mataram, Vande Mataram, Shubhra Jyotsna Pulkitayami, Pulkusumat द्रमदल शोभनी सुहासनी सुमधुर भाषनी सुखदाम्बरदाम मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम। तो भारत वंदना के बाद नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट श्री ए एन तिवारी जी टू प्रोसीड द एजेंडा ऑफ द होटा थाईलैंड फोरम थर्ड मीटिंग।
सो थैंक यू वेरी मच संजय जी, दिस इज अ ग्रेट ऑनर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अवर मीटिंग द थर्ड होटा थाईलैंड मीटिंग एंड वी आर रियली वेरी हैप्पी दैट Sanjay Tripathi ji is joining from San Francisco. We'll be hearing mainly from him all the various things happening in United States. So before we go to that, our one important thing is approval of minutes of the meeting held on the August month, 8th August month. We had already shared the minutes with everybody and hope everything is okay. If anybody have any comment, please do share. If nobody have any comment, I take it as approved, and then I move forward. Now, first I will request Gunaji to give a brief on the importance of collaborative platform of Hindu organization in Thailand by Professor Guna Magijanji, our international coordinator on HOTA. So give us some thought process before we request Sri Sanjay Tripathi ji to give his thoughts on this.
Namaskar everyone. My focus today is rather than giving an importance, because it has been discussed again and again, but I want to bring the importance of how HOTA Thailand is working. See, we have been working on HOTA platform in number of countries, but Thailand having regular meetings is definitely having a positive impact. The number of organizations may not be as in other countries, but that will happen when we have a conference. When we have a major conference, that will definitely happen. As you have seen from the examples of New Zealand and Australia. But keeping these regular meetings, it makes a lot of difference between, in fact, I have got some inspiration from this one that we need to replicate this idea in other countries as well. Because some of the topics that you have chosen, for example, you have invited our Sanjay Tripathi ji from USA to speak on dismantling global Hindutva conference. It is a hot topic, and you have chosen the right topic to bring the right person to speak about it. In fact, this particular conference, we had such an impact in New Zealand as well, because Massey University, where I did my PhD, happened to have supported this conference through one Mohan Datta. I think he's a left-leaning communist. And he runs one center in Massey University. But after Hindu Council and Hota wrote a very strong message to Massey University, they, as a standard one, they replied, I said, this is academic freedom, all nonsense. Huh? But then our young people, especially Hindu youth who are organizing Dharma Fest for Hota, same people said, look, this is not what we are expecting. We should go in a big way. And the youth took initiative in going to the media. The moment they went to the media, everything started happening. And that particular organization within Massey University, which was promoting this Islamophobia and Hindutva, cultural Hindutva, something like that, they closed their website, they closed their Facebook group, everything. So it had such an impact our youth have done. Of course, Hota wrote a similar letter to what Hindu Council wrote, but involving young people in Hindu movement is very, very important, what we have observed. But coming back to Thailand, choosing right topics, bringing right people, I think I'm going to make same suggestion to other countries that we need to follow this pattern, because we will be talking very hot topics. Second, it brings the people, rather than having two functions for Hota for the whole year, the having regular is a very, very positive thing. And the third one is, I think we should, our MC Tiwariji should speak, and he should introduce the speaker rather than bringing me in. This is the third time he has invited, but I think we should avoid that part. Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you, Gunaji. And we really appreciate your advice. But we are in a very nascent stage and we do need hand-holding. So we are not going to leave you, you know, until we can take off. So we will continue doing that. And it is only because of you we are able to get good speakers. You know, we have no way of knowing who is the best in each country. So you are bringing the best to us. And
support everything, Ji. But I think, in fact, you have inspired us to take this idea of having regular 2-monthly meetings in other places. I'm going to make that suggestion.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank
and you. One thing I want to mention is Sanjay Tripathi Ji, of course, Sanjay Kumar Ji, we worked for a number of years. Sanjay Tripathi Ji was the joint coordinator of Hota conference during World Hindu Congress in USA, Chicago. Sanjay, thank you.
Thank you, Ji. Now we move forward. And first of all, I want to give a brief introduction of our next speaker, Parichay of Sanjay Tripathi Ji. You know, you all will be very, very happy to know each of our speakers is expert in their own field. You know, other than Hindu activism or various things being done on Hindu resurgence is part of the assignment, you know, like a hobby, which is more close to the heart, but they all are professional. So he's a computer engineer, professional over 25 years, experience in IT industry, currently working in AMD in GPU and deep learning area. He lives in San Francisco, California, USA, and was originally from Varanasi. He did his graduation from Varanasi. He was also there in Singapore for 8 years and for the last 25 years in the United States. He's a lead community coordinator for California textbook movement to correct the negative representation of India and Hinduism in US school textbooks. you know, most of our members, we only think about our own association, our own own sanstha, and we think you know. But you will find once we go into more and more on OTA activities, we will see how much things are being missed. So, and all this is not possible by any one organization. We all have to join our hands and share our strength to address all those things which are being missed currently. And that is why there is so much attack on Hinduism. He joined the board of Samskrit Bharati in 2019. We all must be knowing Samskrit Bharati is a very fantastic organization. They are bringing Sanskrit, reactivating in the lips and mind of the Bharati society with Sanskrit. Recently, Sanskrit Bharati coordinated with IIT Roorkee to give class, you know, at five levels, you know, from a person who cannot speak any word of Sanskrit, that is the primary. They will make a shivir, and within 2 weeks you start talking in Sanskrit. Then you go one step by step in grammar, in the Shastra knowledge, and five steps. My wife was a Sanskrit scholar in the younger days. She thought, you know, once this came in, she just participated in this activity, and in matter of few months, she got all the five certificate of all five levels. So this is what the power of Sanskrit Bharati. Advisor to Dharma Civilization Foundation, a non-profit to promote authentic study of Hindu Dharma in mainstream universities. Current responsibility is National Sah Karya, National Joint Executive Director in Hindu Swayamsevak USA. He's the head of. So let's welcome Shri Sanjay Tripathi ji. He has immense experience, immense knowledge, and he's worked into all very right organizations. So let's all welcome Sanjay ji. Please, sir.
Sir, Sabhi, sabhi logon ko wish you all. For like we are meeting at the Navratri time, so today is the fourth day, so such a auspicious occasion that we are meeting at the time of Navratri, so it's so wonderful. Gunaji was saying, it was when I was there in World Hindu Congress, and before I came to the Congress, then working with Swamiji, and then got more context about World Hindu Congress, and then about OTA, and then got more interested about all these things, and then got good time to spend with Gunaji also, and to understand how things are, what all things are interesting, what all things we should be planning. So it has been a good experience. And so keeping that in mind, and what before we started, as Gunaji was saying, what all the things we should be thinking about and planning larger things. So I will speak a little bit about the OTA, what all things are being done, and something about the, what do you call this, Dismantling Global Hindutva Conference. But as a, maybe like I would, like do you think, Tiwari ji, that we should be clubbing them separately, or we can just do it in about 25
minutes? No, separately. First, please speak on OTA. You know, OTA is our main focus. But we also want to know that topic in the second speech.
So within the OTA, what are the activities are going on? So the activities are not going on in the name of, sort of, you can say, as a OTA as such organization. But the larger organization which are there in our contact, and who were part of it, who sort of drove it, like whether it's VHP, who was sort of running the whole thing, or with VHP, HSS. So beside them also, now there are a few other organizations which have come up also at the national scene in USA. You all might have seen about COHNA, Coalition of North Hindus, Coalition of Hindus in North America, COHNA. So they also have come up also, organization led by young people, you can think like second generation. So they also have good organization. They have come up. A lot of activism is there. And I'm hoping that they also will be a good resource with respect to our next level of work. So in HOTA, HO is for Hindu organization, T for temples, and A for associations. So when we think about Hindu organization, then good activity is going on. I would say good collaboration with respect to BAPS, Chinmaya Mission, Ammachi, ISKCON, both the groups within the ISKCON also. So that also is going on. Archvidya Gurukulam, that also is going on. And Sangha Parivar, whether it's Seva International, whether it's Sanskrit Bharati, various organizations. You think about Yoga Bharati, different of all. So all those activities are going on and they are being discussed and collaborated. Like Yoga Sangam was done recently by Yoga Bharati. And all the other organizations, they are doing their own program. But nothing like, like under the name of HOTA, that we are doing any activities. But all the activities, all the organizations, they are doing it. And they are aware that World Hindu Congress is coming. In fact, they all are thinking that it's still going to be there in 2022. So in fact, I was speaking to a couple of them, in fact, in the last week. Then I told them, no, it's not 22, it's 23. Because some of them were asking, Sanjayji, what is the correct date? So because they want to book and all those things. And of course, those people were not from Hindu organizations. They were from the associations. So one was from the, once I say associations mean the organizations like of Telugu, Tamil, Sikh, Punjabi, Bengali. So like the person who asked me, who was a speaker into HOTA and WHC, and he's from the Bengali community. And recently one of the consul general, he was like sort of moving away from here. There was a farewell, so he met last Sunday, not this last Sunday. So he met, so he asked, Sanjayji, when the World Hindu Congress is happening, where? Now I know in Bangkok. So it's there into the people's mind, and people will come, people want to come. So that's a good thing that instead of me telling that, they are the one who are asking, Sanjayji, where is the exact day? So
I want to comment on this now on that, because actually, so we have extended that 1 year after the this Congress, but there's not much formal communication from our side that it has been extended. I think we are going to do that before Diwali, that to sell it, to just wish them happy Diwali and also tell them that the Congress has been extended for 1 year. So sorry to interrupt you here.
No, I think Sanjayji, it will be very, very good, because it's there into people's mind and they are thinking about booking and all these things. So it will be very, very good. Thank you, Sanjayji. Wonderful. At least the people who all had come, I think if all of them, they get a note of it, they will percolate this thing into their organizations as well also. Yeah, so it's wonderful. Thank you, Sanjayji. So I was sharing that, yeah. So whether it's a Hindu organizations or whether it's associations, so that work is going on in this way. Like a Hindu Sangathan Diwas is happening, or Diwali gatherings, now Diwali will be coming, Diwali is coming. So a lot of organizations, they are meeting into different ways. There is a new program has started here. I think you all might have noted, Seva Diwali. So Seva Diwali is a program where at the time of Diwali, like all the Hindu organizations or Dharmic organizations, they might be doing the whole year something for the community. But once in a year, the Hindu organizations, they should come together, and at the time of Diwali, because Diwali is sort of known festival, and like in Diwali also is being celebrated in the White House, so people know that the Hindus celebrate Diwali, Hindus, Sikhs, Jains, so this thing, a thought is there, where Buddha. So we thought about that at the time of Diwali, we should be also not only be buying clothes for us, having good food and good party and all these things, but we should be also feeding the local community. So we are planning that, and last year we did. So 179 organizations, they came together, and we collected about £315,000 food, and we donated to 191 charities, pantries, food pantries. So this is the work that we did, and it's not what do you call? It's all organizations. They are coming together, and they all want to do it in the name of Hindu. So we want to make sure that Hindus, mean mainstream Hindus, while having a big paycheck and enjoying a very good life, very good car, very good house, but they also should be feeding to the local community. They should be seen in the community. They should be perceived in the community that they are connecting locally. So this work also is going on. So this work also should help us with respect to our WHC and HOTA, program also, because this also becomes a platform for us also to go and tell about WHC and HOTA easily, because there are like, at this time we are thinking about maybe double it or maybe triple it also. Let's see. This thing started only about 3 days, 4 days back, started from Navratri, and it will end after Diwali, one more week. So it's about like 45 days program, 6 weeks program. And we will be going in, and it's like all the organizations like Chinmaya Mission, they would be their members, their all the branches, they are free to go anywhere to give any food pantry, whatever the food they collect, the member over there. The only thing is that they should come and they should tell that under the Hindu name, that they are the Hindu people who are feeding, because this name of Hindus also do seva should come to the mainstream. The whole idea is it also becomes a shield for us. If there is an attack, anything on us, this also becomes a shield that no, they're good people. They're also helping. They're in the community. So that also is a effort going on. This thing will help us also. So this is the Hindu organization. And with the associations also, we are working in the same way. Temple, again, just very quickly. Okay. So temple also, recently, HMEC, which is sort of within the VHP, one track is there, Hindu Mandir Executive Council. So recently, you all would have seen BAPS issue, a challenge in BAPS temple in New Jersey. So you can think like that also gave an opportunity sort of again to restart and connecting to all the temples. And we had a first call, and 67 or 68 temples, their team came about 2 months back, we had a call. So 110 plus people came, and they represented about 70 temples. So to know and understand what are things are going on, what are the challenges can come for us. And now we are working, we are trying to meet to all the temples, and some sort of that all the temples in America, they don't have any discrimination and are like, if you all have followed that BAPS case in New Jersey, they are trying to make the very big temple. So just like they have got in Delhi and in one in Gujarat, they want to build a very, very big temple. So there is a backlash, and they are saying that it's about Dalit issue and caste issue and discrimination. So all those things are coming up. So now we are working and making sure that the BAPS also is working with us, and we are trying to go to all the temples, tell them about some of the issues which might come for them also. So we want to make sure that we connect with all the temples. So because of that reason, we are reconnecting with all the temples. Maybe like last few years, HMEC was not happening, and we were not like, or maybe happening also, but not so vibrant. But slowly and slowly, HMEC, the team also, they have been, team has been formed, a new team has come, and VHP team also has been like a new team in America. So fresh blood also is there, a lot of passion, drive things. You all might have seen the multiple activities that they are doing also. So all those activities also have started, and somehow I think that they also are, if this momentum continues, this thing is going to help us to have a better attendance into the Bangkok HOTA conference also, because if the aware is there, then people also will be coming there to connect also. So maybe I can just stop here. The whole idea is educating the allies. So once we are meeting with them, we are trying to understand, we have sort of made a sort of presentation also to when we are meeting to all the temples, because they need to know as to why we are meeting also. Sometimes they say, what's the agenda? Why do you want to meet all of a sudden? Because you are not meeting for like almost 2 years or 3 years. So why do you want to meet? So we have a very short presentation also, about five or six slides. So we are meeting with them also. We are still showing some of these slides, also discussing with them. So it's more about meeting to the temple board and discussing with them. And hopefully, by the end of it, this whole program, in the next 6 months or so, all the temples will also, this is our objective, that all the temples should have some sort of something written into the temple that like they don't discuss.
आपने कुछ कॉफी वगैरह नहीं लेने पक्का कुछ दूध वगैरह जलेबी के साथ में दूध
हर्षी म्यूट कर लीजिए हर्षी
आप म्यूट कर लीजिए
हर्ष
हर्ष सेठी है
मैं म्यूट कर देता हूँ
आई कैन म्यूट आल्सो
हाँ हाँ या ओके हाँ जी
या सो 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 दिस इज सो वी आर ट्राइंग टू मेक श्योर दैट ऑल द टेंपल्स आल्सो एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम So two things we want to happen from that whole initiative is one is all the temples, they should come up with sort of something into like na, that all the businesses they have that we are a better business bureau type certificate that we have all the equal opportunity. The same way all the temples also should come up with something that we don't discriminate. So that people say that no, it's caste is there and all the things. That's one thing. And secondly, that once we have a good number of temples who are agreeing to all these things, then we want to make a sort of a more messaging also about it to by sending a note to some of the senators, some of the governors, to the president of America, something like that. So that plan also is there, that once we have got good enough support. So that also, VHP team is working on that. And wherever the VHP team is strong, so they are the one who are working on those things. Wherever they are not, so HSS is sort of a main helping out. Making sure that our shakhas are there, so at least HSS can provide that type of a help, local help. So maybe I can just stop here because you all might be having some questions, and so then maybe we can then I can try to respond some of those things because I think I spoke quite a bit. Yeah, then
I have one question. You are mentioning about Bab Swaminarayan Temple. The one you are mentioning is at Robertsville, New Jersey, right?
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah. And it came in news that they put it, you know, that minimum wage issue, on a very, very trivial issue for a, you know, somehow they will put a spin. They will bring a non-existent problem as a big problem, and many people who are not very aware of all the things. They will start having they will have prejudice towards the Hinduism. So, taking this example, can you give us, guide us more? Because usually the Hindu phobic people, they will attack one organization at a time. And they will try to dismantle them. And then, another time they will target some other association. So at a singular level, it is difficult to safeguard themselves. So how is the HOTA or advocacy or various front is operated, to give a protection and give a right image? Tell us a little bit more on this.
Okay. So Sanjayji, can we not record this thing, if you don't mind, or this is a must?
With very few members. Hello, can you hear me? Yeah, so it was done in a hybrid form, and so the few members attended the puja, but it was mostly broadcast on the Facebook, on YouTube and all. But we made sure prasads were distributed by to their respective addresses, and as many members whom we could do almost whether it was a ISKCON or Sindhi Association or even Embassy or Gita Ashram, everywhere we send them. So that is what we are trying to connect. Similarly, we extended support of vaccination. There are many people who are not getting the appointment and all. We try to support as many people as we can through under the banner of HOTA. So that we are finding some simple things by which we can be more as a bigger team. We as a seva activity, there's an ongoing seva every week. there's something happening on flood relief, on poor people, we are giving rice, and ongoing activities. So all this work are going on there. Besides that, we have regularly doing Know Your Tradition, because our young children are forgetting. We are doing, you know, Navratri. Why we are doing Navratri? Or we are doing, you know, any activity, why we are doing. So this is also we are sharing in OTA platform. So any member from any association are interested, they can learn about it. So this is how we are trying to spread, said that there is a lack of, you know, misinformation should not be there. So this is a few things I can tell on behalf of VHP. And I think some members have to leave because they had some other thing to end because of Navratri. Now I like to request Guna Mangeshan ji to sum up, you know, his thoughts for today's event. Can you unmute? Unmute.
Thank you, Tiwari ji. I think it is, as I mentioned when we started also, bringing right people to discuss right topic, to motivate, inspire all Hindu organizations, association and temples to come together, it is a great thing. And as I also mentioned earlier, the system Hota Thailand has done is a very, although it was like a starting one, they wanted to learn about Hota from different places, but this itself has become a movement. In fact, this is a positive thing that has come out of Thailand, which we need to possibly replicate in other countries as well. Yeah, you mentioned about the Hota. Officially, Hota USA was recently new, but they had something called HMAC, which was trying to bring more temples rather than other association and organizations. They were more focusing on temples. So that is sort of a background for Hota as well. Yeah, is an extension. It is good that you are bringing number of organizations, Hota members from Thailand to speak. And I think it is a very positive thing because other people come to know about it. In fact, when New Zealand started this whole Hindu movement under the leadership of Swami Vigyananji's guidance, the first conference that we organized was with the theme Hindu contribution, the contribution of Hindu community to New Zealand society. I think this would be a very good topic when, you know, what you called, when the corona lockdown system goes down. I think OTA should run a conference called Hindu contribution to Thailand society, you know, each organizations, what they have, like what we are hearing from, for example, Gita Ashram, other organizations, same thing, if it has come as a conference where so many people come together, I think Hota will grow very well. Thank you, ji. Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you, Guna ji. Now, I request Sanjay ji to end the today's meeting after announcing the next meeting date. And the next organization who will take it forward.
Okay. Hold on. Okay. Thank you so much, Tiwari ji, for taking lead in the Hota Thailand Forum third meeting. Gunaji's review of conclusion of this today's meeting is again extremely important, because we are yet to reach to the goal, maybe with the beginning of next year. This year we are just like a knowledge sharing, learning opportunities, understanding each other, that the goal of hotel now. And I think, I don't know when many of you remember or not, last time Gunaji said 2-3 things about like, I don't know if I remember, like growing together. What was the?
Coming together, working together, and growing together.
Okay, these are the keywords. I think if I belong to a marketing side, so I want to put this, our motto of Hota Thailand, come together, working together, and growing together. This is the crux of everything what we have discussed so far. What Suresh Mutrejaji spoke briefly, but I think he has hit the right point. That hum darte kyun hai? Why we fear to come together? As a Hindu, hum log, we are doing very well at the individual level. But when it comes to the organization, when we come to the representing Hindu society in Thailand, in overseas, we are not very proactive. And so I think the more proactive approach, more Hindu activism, and required in Thailand with very sensitivity towards the local Buddhist culture. There are something that we need to take care of the local side as well. So I believe in the Sanjay Tripathiji said that we have to, certain things we can work in the public in front, but many things we have to do at the backside also, like working from the behind the scene. Behind the scene is our preparation, working, keeping our house in order. And we decide what we have to project to the outer world. So this is exactly important, Sanjay Tripathiji in Thailand, that we have to do lots of homework behind the scenes and then pick up few points what we want to carry forward to the public. So we keep learning from all the organizations now. Especially, I want to learn more about the Gita Ashram's initiative of providing scholarships. This is something very, very unique initiative done by Gita Ashram, but I think many people don't know about that. Even I also don't know, believe me.
We'll invite you next time.
I heard about it, but I did not know about this much about it. But I think this is something very unique thing that you are doing. Being a Hindu organization, and as I said, Sureshji, don't feel, but I want to tell you one thing that if we, in Thailand, if we want to succeed Hota, we need to concentrate on three organizations only. One is Dev Samaj, Hindu Samaj, Ji Dev Mandir. Second is Vishnu Temple, Hindu Dharam Sabha. Third is Gita Ashram. And fourth is...
Aapki awaaz kat gayi.
I think his feed is frozen.
आपकी आवाज कट गई. ये इंटरनेट इज अनस्टेबल समटाइम.
वी हैव लॉस्ट यू संजय जी.
आई एम कंक्लूडिंग. या सो बेसिकली
आपका फोर्थ पॉइंट नहीं आया.
कट गया.
कौन सा नहीं आया? कौन सा पॉइंट? ऑडिबल आफ्टर द फोर्थ पॉइंट. बिफोर द फोर्थ पॉइंट प्लीज.
या वी लॉस्ट योर वॉइस.
व्हाट वाज द फोर्थ पॉइंट? थर्ड पॉइंट.
वेल यू नो द फोर्थ पॉइंट.
Okay, anyway, I just want to tell that if we want to succeed Hota in Thailand, there are four or five things that I want to mention here, organization. One is the Hindu Samaj, Sri Dev Mandir. Okay. Second is Vishnu Temple, Hindu Dharam Sabha. Third is Gita Ashram, Thailand. Fourth is like ISKCON, Sindhi Temple, AIT Hindu Association.
Bab Swaminarayan.
Swaminarayan. So this is a cluster four. But I think 70% of the Hindu population belongs to three big temples. Vishnu Mandir, Dev Mandir, and Gita Ashram. So I think if we somehow can pick up this very strong influence in these three or four clusters of Hindu organizations, I think Hota will succeed and grow together. But I think it's a beginning, and I hope this year we are learning. Next year we'll have more activity oriented work we can do together, and at the legislative level, and what I pick up some areas where we can work together. But meanwhile, I think we share information what we are doing, and we encourage each other, and we work together, come together, and prosper us together, grow together. That is the key area. And I think I would like to highlight these three points in our publicity material next time. that our goal is come together, work together, and grow together. Thank you, Gunaji, and everybody.
I just need a minute.
What
Gunaji mentioned, we should plan to have a OTA World Forum meet, physical meet in 2022, if conditions permit.
Yeah, absolutely.
That will give our organization more exposure.
Yeah,
many people
absolutely.
Do not know. Today I was attending another charity event and I mentioned to them that I have to rush to a OTA meeting. So many people were not aware what is OTA.
Yeah,
so that shows that, you know, there is still ignorance. So we should have a meet and highlight it and, you know, give good exposure to it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
So let me sum up now. So first of all, I would like to thank our guest speaker, Sri Sanjay Tripathi ji from America. Thank you so much for your great insight. We know you very well. We met many times. Hope you will come to Thailand next time when we have a conference here. Then I always thank you, Gunaji, for Gunaji is our mentor of OTA. And not only in Thailand, he has to take care of the multiple countries. So Gunaji, I think in addition to this meeting, if you can have a one platform, let's say once in 6 months, like a global OTA meeting, that could be a leading part from, okay, we have picked up certain people from the Thailand, from Fiji, from Australia, New Zealand, America, and from the South America. And then we like have some kind of a 50-60 global discussion so that we can sum up actually what is happening for Hindus around the world, you know. So that could be like once in 6 months, not every month, not in 2 months. So this is the model of Thailand. We do every once in 2 months, but for you, it can be like once in 6 months, like that, you know, online or offline. Online is better now for a while. And I thank you all the representative organizations, Shailesh Upadhyayji from BAPS, Govindji, Ramesh Upadhyayji, and Suresh Putrajaji. Thank you for coming first time. And I think you have raised a very correct point. And we'd like to build up some momentum from there itself. And then both Tiwariji and me are hosts. So basically we don't have to thank ourselves, but we feel very thankful to all of you for shaping up the OTA of Thailand Forum. So let's meet again in December. And I think Geeta Ashram done, BAP. So I will check who will chair the...
I tell you, the next one will be by alphabetical order.
Yeah.
Sunday, 12 December, and HSS will do.
HSS, okay.
Yeah.
So we'll
Hindu
Swayam Sevak Sangh. So I talked to Ashish Karpe ji. He's our Karyavah here.
Today, Ashish Karpe ji and Umesh Mishra ji, I talked both of them. They have another meeting, you know. So it's clashing. Yeah.
So HSS is doing a lot of work in Thailand, Sanjay ji, just to let you know. Every day they have done this 6:06 in the morning. It's called East Chintan every day. And they are doing lots of seva activities as well, and Shakha, and also, and I think that the base of the volunteers is increasing every year. We have a number of volunteers, Swayamsevaks, RSS, Shakha, and seva activities, and also the regular Chintan Baithak, and doing the many the good thing that HSS Thailand, that they are very active in online activities also, even the pandemic. So just to let you know that VSP Thailand and HSS Thailand, they're both very active organizations, even in the COVID-19. And actually not only these, but all the associations, as I said, that they're doing very well at the individual level. All we need to have a combined strength to make a OTA forum more successful. I think this will come up next year. So with that, I would like to, everybody please sit in a comfortable position. We have a Shanti Mantra.
Unmute please, and Shanti
Mantra. Just follow me, please. Follow me better. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah.
Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah.
Om Sarve Santu Niramaya.
Sarve Santu Niramayah.
Niramaya.
Om Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu.
Om Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu.
Om Akashe Dukh Bhag Bhavet.
Om Akashe Dukh Bhag Bhavet.
Om Shanti शांति शांति
ओम शांति शांति शांति.
थैंक यू सो मच जी एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू 12 दिसंबर अनदर होटा मीटिंग एंड देन विल कैरी फॉरवर्ड. Thank you, Sarej bhai. For the no baad, I call you back. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Namaskar ji. Namaskar.
Namaskar. Thank you so much. Thank you, Tiwari ji. Good job.
Thank you, Sanjay ji. Thank you.